Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Tonight we're going to talk about Spring Boot, and it's actually just a small trick that I actually know that I would just like to spread out to you. So it's not a huge thing tonight. It's just that in Lombok there's something called Required Constructor, and you can use this to inject all the beans you want to inject in your component, in your service, or in your controller in Spring. So let us just jump right into it. I've already created a project right here. I pressed File, Project, New Project, and then I chose Spring Initializer, and then I went Next, and then I chose Good Package. I chose Java 13, Gradle, and gave a good name, Next, and then I ticked off Lombok, and then I ticked off Web, Spring Web, it's there. Then I ticked off H2 Database and JPA, like this. And then I press next finish, and then I ended up with this project that I have right here. And I haven't added any code yet at all. So let us do that together. So we can actually let us create something called, I'm right clicking, nothing here. Yeah, there it comes. New package. Then we can create a new package called spaceship, something like that. As usual, we have created the spaceship a lot of times, so let us just do it very fast. We'll create an entity, and then we'll create a repository, and then we'll create a controller that does something. And when we do this, of course, we need to inject the repository into the controller. So I'll just create a spaceship like this, spaceship. Another thing I did, actually, when I started up this project, and I went and enabled annotation processor right here. Annotation processing, and then I ticked off this enable annotation processing, so then IntelliJ knows how to handle the Lombok annotations. The spaceship, that is a data type, because what we will actually get is we will get the to string method, we will get getters and setters, and we'll get the default NoArgs constructor by default. And we'll also get a good equals method that which will reduce all the fields. But let us just give it two fields. So we give it a name, string name, and then we give a number of crew members, like this. And then I'll create a repository. So I'll create an interface. It's called spaceship repository, like this. Repository, and this will extend the usual repository like this, and the entity is a spaceship. And of course, now I forgot to add an ID, but the ID will be an entity. I'll just add it right now. So I'll go back to spaceship, I'll add an ID, and we'll give this should be the private entity ID, like this. And we need to give it generated value, and then we will actually say that the strategy is auto. That's actually default. Like this, here it is. So now, and we will also enable, we set it as an entity. Like this, and that should actually be it. So now the repository should be heavy. Then we will also create a controller, and this is where we're using the injection. This is where we need the injection. So I'll call the spaceship controller, and inside this controller, it's a REST controller like this. And now here comes the magic, or the cool stuff. Because we can actually wire stuff several ways. I can write auto wired, and I can actually write spaceship repository like this, spaceship repository. And of course, if I do this, then I'll get a warning, because this is not the way to do it. It's very difficult to test this, so field injection is not recommended, as this warning says right here. We should actually inject it with a. We should actually constructor inject it. So we should actually create a small constructor instead. And then Spring will actually inject it when it's creating this an instance of this class right here. If I write private final, then I can actually just have IntelliJ to create my constructor. Then I can write add constructor parameter like this, And that's actually it. And then now I would actually get my repository injected here. And yeah, and we could actually use the repository after this in some kind of method where we could return some REST codes, maybe a list of spaceships. I'll just write that list. And then we'll say spaceship. Spaceships. And then I'll just return spaceship repository. Okay, I misspelled it a lot. Actually, that's, I'm not good at spelling tonight, but let us just change it. Spaceship repository, repository like this. Okay, change it. Oh, I forgot to change the parameter also. Spaceship repository. Okay, it's because the class was also misspelled. Oh, okay, how nice. I'll just also refactor this repository like this. Let's just, spaceship repository. Okay, I should have said yes also to change this, the constructor argument right here. But nevertheless, now we have a spaceship repository, and then we can write find all. And that could actually be something like an iterable, like this, iterable. Let's just say void and then have IntelliJ to help us out here. I don't need to write it. So, iterable spaceships. So this would actually just return all the spaceships, and then we could have some get mapping like this, and then we could say API and then spaceship like this, and then we will return all the spaceships. But there is actually an even easier way, because let's say that I have multiple repositories. Maybe I also had some helper service. I'll just create a space station service that we needed. Space station service. Let's say we have one of these, and this is a service. And this service, it, of course, right now I can just even leave it empty. But let us say that I actually need it. Maybe. We can have it to string, public string name, and then we can just return huge space station, or we can system out this or something, or log this. We can also log it if you want to. We can actually add SL4J right here, and then actually I can return it, but we can also just log it, log.info huge space station. So let's say that we actually needed this inside our spaceship controller. We need the space station controller. Then I would also have to add that like this, private final space station service like this, space station service. And then again, I would need to add it in a constructor variable, and now Spring will actually inject it. In old days, I had to write something like auto-write right here, but that's actually not necessary anymore to get it injected. But that's actually an even easier way, because this is a bit ugly, this piece of code right here. I would actually like to remove that, and we can do that with Lombok, and that's what tonight's trick is about. We can actually write required args constructor with Lombok. If I have this, then I can just remove this constructor right here, and then the constructor will actually be auto-generated. Spaceship station service, and then I can actually write name, and then we can use that so it's actually used. So that's actually the trick. I know it's a small thing, but I think it just makes the code a lot nicer to look at. So yeah. That's actually it. If I should mention another thing, then there's something called value, which is not used that much. And if you really like immutable code, then you should actually use the add value as much as possible. Lombok has something called value. Like we can just create something. Let's say we have a message or something like that. We have a message for some people. Message. For the people in space. If I say this is a value, Lombok value, then I would actually only get, I would only have getters for my fields. It means that if I have a private string name, or maybe a message, or maybe it's content, and maybe the message, it has a person which needs to receive it, so it has a receiver. And it also has a sender. And I would like this information to be immutable, because I would really make sure that no one fudges the content, the receiver, or the sender, because yeah, the message just need to get to the person where that actually needs to read this message. And now that I added at value, then you can actually see here what kind of annotations I get automatically. We will get the getter. We have something called the field defaults. That's something with the scopes. And then we have the all art constructor. So that means that I will get a constructor with all the fields. I will only get getters. That means I cannot manipulate them afterwards. I'll get the to string. I'll get the equal and hash code. That means that I can compare messages. And then I'll also get the data. And the data, of course, it also includes equals and hash code, and also includes to string. Yeah. So let us try that. We'll just go back, and then I can go back down in my controller here, and then we can actually create some code up here. Can create a new message. Message m equals new. Message, and then right here, then I need to add my content. Hello, space station, and the receiver, that could be the captain of the space station, and the sender, that's Mike, that's me. And so now I have my message, and you can see here I only have getters, so I cannot manipulate it. I cannot go in and set the message, the content, or the receiver and sender. And if I want to compare this message with other messages, then I can just use the equals, because this equals is actually overridden. So that means that it will actually look at all the fields inside when it should decide if they're equals or not. And I just think it's really cool. And as soon as I have the chance to add value, then to add the add annotation value, then I will actually do that, because then you actually get an immutable pattern in your code. Of course, it's difficult to use some entities, because entities we want to change these before we save them into the database. Many times we want to get entities from the database and want to manipulate them and then send them once again. I'm not sure. Let's just, okay, we can see if the application actually works. Let's just try to see what happens. But the main trick I want to show is the required args constructor. It's really, really cool, and it saves us from a lot of code. It does all injection for us, because it actually creates a constructor. I had an error somewhere. Let me just check. Entity manager factory defined blah 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 blah. What is wrong with my no identifier specified for spaceship? Let me just go check spaceship. I have this identifier right here. Oh, it was the wrong identifier. I need the persistence, JavaX persistence. This is the ID I wanted. So it's because I took the wrong annotation. Let's see. Yep, now started. Let's go check. There's no spaceships added right now, so it's actually a bit boring. I just wanted to show that the application actually works. We should just get an empty array copy. Then I'll go out to localhost 8080 API spaceship. And here we have the raw data, and that's an empty array. And that's very, very cool. That means that our application actually works. Of course, if you want some spaceships inside to play with, but then we can actually create a new class. We could also use one of the existing classes, and then we can initialize some data there. Then we could call it init spaceships, like this. And then we could annotate this for component. And then we could have something with post construct, like this. And then we could have a public void create create spaceships like this. And now I will actually need the spaceship repository like this, repository. And again, if I add the required args constructor, then I don't need to authorize somehow. And then I write, of course I need to remember it should be private final, because what Lombok does is it actually looks for private final and then says, oh, okay, these, they need to be set in a constructor because they cannot be set at any other point in time, because the developer, he actually set final in it, on it, and he also set the private. The private is not that important, the important part is actually the final. So it means it needs to be set in the constructor, that's the only place it can actually be set. And that's why it will be included in the required args constructor when that is generated. The constructor for that is generated. So now I can actually just use my repository. It means that I can save. And then we can write a new spaceship like this, new spaceship. And ID should be null. Oh, in the spaceship we should actually add the all args constructor. That will make life a little bit easier for us. We can also add the builder. If you want to add the builder pattern, then we could also do that. Builder pattern, so that means that then I can actually write something like spaceship.builder, and I can set the name. The name is round, and then I can set the crew number. One, it was 12, and then I can just write build. So then now I'm adding, and I'll just add one spaceship. Then I can add, of course, multiple of these. So we can have a pyramid spaceship with another number of crew members like this. And then we can have a square and a pentagon and a hexagon. So, and then we can restart our application, and then if I did not create too many errors, then we'll actually get these spaceships added to the H2 database. Let us just go refresh the page right here. That was an error, internal error. What did it say? No default constructor. Yeah, I forgot the default constructor for spaceship. So I'll just go back and create that. No args constructor with Lombok. And then I'll run again. With the API, and when you convert objects to JSON, then you need the default constructor, or else JSON doesn't know how to convert it into JSON. It cannot create a new instance, and that's its problem. So let us just start the application again, see what happens. Hope there was an error here. What is that now? No default constructor for spaceship. I just created that, right? No args constructor is right there. And we can also add the all args constructor. Let us just see what happens. Yeah, so now started, and let us just check. API spaceship here, we have all the spaceships now. Crew, round, pyramid, hexagon, pentagon, square, etc. I know this was a small trick, but I just think it saves a lot of code, so that's why I wanted to show it to you. I really like it. Required args constructor just saves the constructor itself, and we can just define the stuff that are in the context, all the objects that are created, all the singletons, because it is singletons. Whenever we create a REST controller or something like that, then it is we only get one instance of them. So it is kind of a singleton. Spring creates one version of this, and then that's it. And then it gets injected. Then it gets injected here in the constructor, and that's why it's so cool and clean with the required args constructor. But that was it. Thank you very much for listening to me. Of course, if you like this video, I would appreciate it if you click like, and if you subscribe, then you'll get more content from me in the future. Or else, just have a very nice evening, and I hope to see you again very soon. Bye-bye.